Kane is in the building, nigga.
I am Kane Beatz. I'm from Orlando, Florida, 24 years old. I've been producing since high school. I pretty much started out in high school. I had a rap group, me and my homeboys. I realized, you know, I was just way better at making beats than actually rapping. So, you know, I started producing in high school, kept it going. And, you know, in college, I ended up working with Trick Daddy, did Tuck Your Icing, and, you know, really went on from there. I worked with Lil Wayne, Trey Songz, Lupe Fiasco, Nicki Minaj, Drake, Rick Ross, Plies, you know, anybody you can name it in hip-hop, all types of things. Like, thing about me, man, I always try to, like, if you listen to my records, they all sound different. You know? Like, I try to always make something sound different. So I'm always, even if I'm doing a club record, I want to be different from the last record I did. If I'm doing a pop record, I want to be different from the last record I did. Steady Mobbing, man, that record was crazy. I remember just being in my apartment. I was actually supposed to go in with OJ the Juice, man. So I did a record. I decided, I was like, yo, I'm going to make this record. Made the record. He didn't come through. I went in with Titty Boy, and then he ended up taking it to Wayne. So Wayne heard the record. Wayne jumped on it. I think Gucci jumped on it. And Wayne ended up just keeping the record. Wayne, so creatively, he already has his lane. He already knows what he's going to do. So when you're working with Wayne, you kind of just, you know, you're in the studio, let him do what he wants to do. He's going to take it where he wants to go. And your job really is there, you know, to help him get his vision where he wants to be. And so when I first started making Steady Mobbing, I found his VST named Slim. So I was working on the record, pulled up the VST, and it was the very first sound I found. So I hit the sound, and it sounded like arpeggiator's crazy sound right there. So then I just started messing with it, playing with it, and I came up with this. This was the first part I did on the beat, and I just came up with this part. You know, basically just ran with that, and then just made the bass around that, started working on the other sounds. Just really basically just a simple bass, and then, you know, I just started working on the drums. Kick I use right here instead of mobbing, just, you know. And it was just, you know, basic crazy kick I have. I use it in so many records though, but I EQ it and change it every time. My brother came about, it was a record I was doing in the studio working, you know, and when I mess with trumpets, I kind of have this progression I always mess around with. It's always like, if you listen to The Show Goes On, or right above it, the trumpets are kind of that similar progression. So, you know, I was just messing on the keyboard, and this just basically came up with, you know. You know, just real simple, catchy melody, but it was anthemic. And I found the same VST I did Steady Mobbing, and I was just going through sounds, and I found this sound. And I just was messing with it and came up with the melody, like.
She Michael Jackson bad. I'm attracted to her, but her attractive bad.
When I first started making records, I was selling beats on the internet, and I was trying to, you know, place myself different from everybody else. So I'm like, yo, I want to get somebody's attention as soon as the record comes on. So I'm like, yo, Kane is in the building. And I'm like, yo, I'm just going to say Kane is in the building, nigga. And that's just right there, you know. Once people hear that, it's like, oh, man. And then when you hear it more than one time, you start to, you know, brand the producer with the music and with the tag. So, you know, hit him with the
Kane is in the building, nigga.
And you know it's a smash, though. As soon as you hear it, it's like
Kane is in the building, nigga.
Man, you know it's going down right now. You know what I'm saying?
Kane is in the building, nigga.
I'll turn the music up as loud as you possibly can.
Kane is in the building, nigga.
Girls are like, oh my god, my song is about to come on. I just look at, I always think about what I haven't accomplished yet. You know what I'm saying? There's so much, I've done a lot, but it's so much like the people who I look up to. They've done so much more. So at the same time, I mean, I'm in here, but I'm trying to create my own. So, you know, in the process of just creating and working on myself and working with others, I'm always looking at, like, what else there is to do. So, I mean, in my opinion, I haven't accomplished nothing I'm trying to get to yet. I haven't accomplished my goals all the way yet. I've gotten a lot done, but, I mean, it's still a lot to do. So that's just, you know, the force that keeps me driving every day. The force that keeps me like, yo, this is where I'm, I feel like this is where I'm supposed to be, you know what I mean?
Ooh, baby, I be stuck to you like glue, baby, wanna spend it all on you.